Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here, and welcome to part two of our algae control video series, where we help you identify and tackle some of the peskiest nuisance algae that can grow in your aquarium. Now, we went over this in the first video, but I think it's really important to say it again. The first step in battling any nuisance algae problem is to ensure that all of your water parameters are in check. Using pure RODI water, performing regular water changes, not overfeeding your aquarium, and using an efficient protein skimmer are all going to help in your battle against nuisance algae. Bubble algae is actually kind of cool looking if you ask me, but it is one of the hardest algae to deal with in your tank. Bubble algae grows quickly, and it is important to remove it right away before it has time to spread. When removing this algae, do not pop the bubbles, as this will release spores that will then spread throughout your tank. You want to carefully remove the little green bubbles with a turkey baster or outside of the tank to avoid spreading the algae around. Now, thankfully, bubble algae is pretty easy to keep out of your aquarium with proper quarantine practice and close inspection of all your new frags and corals, because bubble algae is really easy to see and identify. Emerald crabs, foxface, and other rabbit fishes are widely known to eat bubble algae, and this might be a good addition if you find bubble algae growing in your tank. Turf algae is somewhat similar to green hair algae, as it is a generic term that refers to a wide variety of species that look alike. The coarse, wiry mats of algae seem to sprout right out of your rocks and can really be difficult to remove. Even a heavy scrubbing outside of the tank can prove ineffective against turf algae. Controlling nutrients along with a cleanup crew helps to prevent this algae from getting out of control. Urchins and emerald crabs are your best choice. If you find it growing heavily in your tank, it is probably best to remove the rocks or frags and clean them outside of the aquarium. A turf algae problem is one of the cases where an algicide or peroxide can help, but is best treated outside of the tank and be sure to do your research first. Macroalgae is really beneficial in reef tanks in terms of nutrient control. The trick here though is to get it to grow in the right place, such as in your refugium, and keep it out of your display tank. Bryopsis is a pesky macroalgae that, if left to grow in your display, can be unsightly and outcompete corals for real estate in the tank. Cleaner crew animals are not all that effective at controlling Bryopsis, so manual removal at the first signs of this algae is very important. Nutrient control via water changes and filter media is also important to slow down the spread of Bryopsis. Unfortunately, just like turf algae, if this stuff is left to grow wild in your tank, it is likely that you'll need to remove and clean all of the infected rocks outside of the aquarium. One remedy that's proven to be successful in removing some species of Bryopsis is elevating your magnesium levels to 1700 to 1800 parts per million using Kent Marine Tech M. Now, you want to raise your magnesium levels 100 parts per million per day. Be careful and do your research first though, because elevated magnesium levels can actually harm your corals and your fish if not done properly. Dinoflagellates are unique and can easily be confused with diatoms or even cyanobacteria. It is brown and stringy and produces air bubbles that get trapped up in the filaments. Dinoflagellates can be a real pain if they get out of control. A cleaner crew will not consume dinos, and manual removal is your best choice. Many hobbyists remove and treat infected rocks outside of the tank, usually to the point of killing and cleaning the rock completely. Nutrient control helps prevent an outbreak, so be sure to maintain your water parameters accordingly. Because dinoflagellates are photosynthetic, blacking out your tank for a few days has also been reported as an effective means of control. Algae is one of those things where an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. By maintaining your water parameters, keeping your nutrients under control, practicing proper quarantine, and observing your tank closely, you can easily keep any one of these nuisance algae from becoming a problem in your reef tank. Continuum Aquatics offers a natural solution to combat and prevent algae problems. The BacterClean M helps to naturally reduce and eliminate algae by using microbial cultures and enzymes to break down waste and dislodge algae for easy removal. Remember, algae is a natural and crucial part of the ecosystem in your aquarium and will surely exist, but maintaining a proper balance is the key to success. If you're battling a frustrating nuisance algae problem, our trained team of aquarium experts is here to help you out. We do want to send a special thank you to the online reefing community for providing most of the footage and photos that you've seen in this video today. For all of those who contributed, Marine Depot really appreciates your support. We do thank all of you for watching, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.